damn it.
I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression.
I don't believe it.
Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do.
For
we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help the future. It has never been easy, and our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that before you are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Yeah, give him back already. Well, I thought it was going to go down. Look at all this tech in here. It's just crazy. Sean. Sean.
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
You son of a...
Sean.
Who?
S923, recall code 6.
What? What the hell?
A disappointment. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a perfect. You understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli.
What?
Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Where's my son?
Give me Sean. The real Sean. Right now!
I know. I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him. Promised answers, and answers you shall have. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time.
What?
It's me.
What?
Your son.
Bullshit.
It's really you. After all this time.
Yes. It's true. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the sun. But then you learned that your son was no longer anything but a 10-year-old boy. Institute believed humanity's future depended on it.
Sean, come on.
The year 2227. The Institute had made great strides in synth production. It was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever on. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being. Walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why we took you.
In a manner of speaking. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical
style
was, of course, human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted.
Oh!
Wasteland. Radiation affecting everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. Then the Institute found me after discovering records from Vault 111. Frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the colony. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
Sean. It's really you.
It really is. I know you must have questions. Please. Anything I can do to help you understand. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
After what I've seen, I pity the man. He was as much of a victim as anything.
After what he did to you, I'm shocked you would be so generous. But yes, I understand you. Experience things. Perhaps you ended up knowing him better.
I hate that I'm wearing this suit.
Will never truly forget. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan.
Oh yeah, he should have been really old.
Never failed the Institute. But his cruelty became more apparent with every your path crossed this. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge. What else can I say? To ease your mind.
Nothing.
She never got to see you grow up.
Yeah. What happened to her was, I've gone over the records of the incident. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
Collateral damage? Is that all she was to you?
I forget that it's been such a short time for you. I don't have any direct memories. And I've had my entire life to cope with the loss. Has it always been easy? Of course not. But I've done my best to move on. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that. With old age comes regret.
Since it's his son, I don't
know. After all these years, you have an opportunity to help him. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Yes, that's what I want.
I know. I know you've been through so much. I'm pleased to see it has not impaired your judgment. Forgive me. I assume that after everything I'm sure you've seen above ground, you would be more than a bit biased against it. There is much to be done.
There is no
sign. You need time to acclimate yourself. A chance to become acquainted with our procedures.
I'll do whatever it takes. It's worth it.
I am glad.
And Sean's back, so.
The Institute is now your home. Please take some time, get to know me. Meet the people you'll be working with. You want to introduce yourself to the division head, Dr. Fillmore in facility, Dr. Ayo in SRD, Dr. Holdren in bioscience, and finally Dr. Lee in advanced systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next.
But what about Deacon and everybody?